A new phenomenon is screaming up the music charts around the world. It's called K-pop or Korean pop. Names like Psy, The Wonder Girls, Girls Generation and Big Bang are the sensations of this new genre. The music videos are funny, they're colourful, energetic and most of all, they're addictive. Once you've heard Gangnam Style, you just can't stop. Have a listen.
Oppa Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, op, op.
Come on, Nick, you've just got to get into it, don't you? Nick Gulliver is our resident K-pop guru and he joins me at the desk. Nick, Gangnam Style, it's already number 7 here on the Australian ARIA charts.
Yes.
Clearly, we've got the fever.
Everyone's going crazy for Gangnam Style. It's massive, it's blowing up all around the world. Ellen's had him on, he was on the Today Show in the US. Justin Bieber's manager just signed him, so it's huge Korean pop star that's just gone massive.
What's different about it to what we're already seeing and hearing?
Yeah, well, Korean pop music started in the early 90s and really in 2000 really went epically big. Basically, it's super stylized film clips. It's young boy bands, girl bands kind of singing about happy, upgoing kind of stuff. And this song, Gangnam Style, has just kind of caught the world by storm, you know?
It's so easy. I mean, clearly I'm not a big in the clubs these days, no longer, but I could just imagine these songs being so popular in the clubs.
Yeah, well, that's the thing about the Korean, South Korea's pop music is difference between that and other Asian pop music is normally their choruses are in English. They're really super catchy, they're short, and by the time you've listened to the song once, you are addicted to it and you've caught the fever.
And I've got to say, when you see the dance steps, it wouldn't take everyone too long to pick these up. You were saying that he's just now being picked up by Justin Bieber's management.
Yes.
How did this music get out there to such a level so quickly?
Yeah, well, with the kind of influx of social media, this has now gone global. You know, in the past, they wouldn't have been able to get it out of South Korea, but now with YouTube, with Twitter, with Facebook, all these songs are kind of getting out there amongst the community. I mean, YouTube in 2010 started its own K-pop channel, and within this is massive. I mean, Koreans just go crazy for this dude.
And there's a damn lot of them.
Yeah, well, the thing is, he's the equivalent of the Michael Jackson of Korea, and that's the thing. He's been big for the last 10 years. He's had 6 albums, but now we're just getting on to Psy. And, I mean, look at this crowd go. They're totally into it, every step.
It's just stunning to watch. Look at the size of those crowds. Heavens above. Is this a fad that's just going to come and go, or will it have a big influence on what we see as mainstream music?
I think this is going to stay around. I think, this is the first time in history where Asian pop music is really starting to influence Western culture. I mean, through YouTube and Twitter, I mean, anyone can see it. I mean, the dance is so catchy that, you know, it's here to stay.
Well, Nick Gulliver, Gangnam Style, will be doing that all through the commercial break. Thanks very much.